introducing some what means convective atmospheric boundary layer. After that, I came to problems, and after that, to solutions of closure problem, and finally, how we moved in this direction last several years. Okay, this is forecast for today from Misha Grishka, which was done in 2014. And this is why it's forecast, because it's a typical atmospheric convective boundary layer. This simulation was done with Palm LAS. And here it's for polar region. So you can see typical convective feature heating from below, cooling from above, here stratified fluid. But I will show it's more detailed. Red is updrafts, blue is downdrafts. It's в общем, this is typical situation. This is how it looks in mean fields. Mean field is just left-hand side, it's wind, mean wind. Right-hand side, it's potential temperature, but you can imagine it's simply temperature. That here presented LS data from Rush-Ryota, DNS data from WAGU, and measurements from Alfred Wegener Institute by Jörg Hartmann. Okay, I forgotten to tell that if you will see some uncertainties in figures, it's from my colleague. If some uncertainties in equations, from me. Okay. This is geostrophic, it's forced by wind from above, and you have in free atmosphere geostrophic wind, so-called, which is caused by pressure horizontal gradient. Yeah. And due to Coriolis, you have turning and V component appear. Okay, and here you also must have in mind that measurements, this is instantaneous fields, while the DNS, oops, sorry. While DNS, this is blue, and LS, here they are nearly coincide. They are horizontally averaged over domain of simulations. So next step. Now we see deviations from this mean which was shown before. Here it's the potential temperature fluctuations. They here with prime. And this is side view. You have updrafts from below and downdrafts from roof from above. It's data. And here, the view from above in on this line in the middle of the boundary layer. And you can see that wind in this direction. So you can see the organization of plumes in some sort of strings. And temperature in vertical velocity, you have this is called so-called organized coherent structure or simply plumes. You just here they are small size and surface layer. After that, they growing in size, and in the middle they are represented like this. So now old standing questions. I must stress that I will talk only about 1D decay, if question arises about multidimensional features, I just will comment. And here there are what does not work? There is no downgradient heat transport. There are no downgradient transport for third order moments. Okay. And return to isotropy also doesn't work as in homogeneous turbulence. And finally, famous Milyonchikov hypothesis, sometimes called quasi-normality assumption in NDQNM framework and so on, also does not work. So because all these features in high-order closure models are brackets means average, ensemble average, and in LS it's area averages. So because in high-order closure models everything comes from Milyonchikov hypothesis, it's the same for kinetic equation, for closure models. And I will just analyze this only, these problems. Milyonchikov hypothesis was discovered in 41. And story of discovering of Millionchikov hypothesis, it states that in all turbulence models, four order moments can be considered as Gaussian, while third order moments completely non-Gaussian can be. And history of discovering of this, it's known because still survive people who was present in process of discovering that Millionchikov came to the lecture, Kolmogorov make his seminar, small. Millionchikov came, he was excited and tell that closure does not work, equations which he averaged nonlinear now he talks does not work. And Kolmogorov turned back and tell make it Gaussian. And after that, everything started to work and so here I will demonstrate how Millionchikov hypothesis is presented in real signals. This is horizontal wind fluctuations. For them, of course, Gaussianality is working because it's some sort of nearly homogeneous, and you can see. So what is shown here, here is the signal. Typical, here it's PDF. Gray one is Gaussian, so you can see that deviation from Gaussian is not very huge, actually very small. And here scatter plot which show Gaussian behavior versus real measurements from this signal, and everything is working perfect. But life is not so good for temperature fluctuation. Here you immediately can see huge deviation here from the Gaussian behavior, okay? And also this is clearly seen in PDF. You don't need even to plot Millionchikov curve by looking simply on PDF. This is Gaussian. So we can expect then. So next step. This is what was known. In 2002, me and Jörg Hartmann, we made some very simple trick. We just decided, okay, we will take, I'm talking about temperature, but the same was done for velocity components also. We take Gaussian, and we take very simple four delta model, which is called sometimes mass flux, sometimes coherent structure model, and so on. But it's, I will explain later what is this. And after that, we suggest the simple linear interpolation between two regimes. That we tell everything is combined from very skewed Gaussian turbulence, non-Gaussian turbulence. This is skewness, which is definition, standard, nothing new here. And so we tested this trick. And you see all these points move exactly on this line. So this is a new closure, which was called refined Millionchikov hypothesis. Why it's refined? Because here, these two terms, this first term, it's exactly coincide with Millionchikov, and skewness correction, it's refinement. Okay? So, and we become happy with this, because it works, and at the same time, we looked at some next step. If it works for refined Millionchikov hypothesis, we just made the trick that, okay, in turbulence, it's allowed to make additional fitting constant, and we just extended Millionchikov hypothesis by adding here 10 fitting constant for 5 moments. And here there is the exercise. There are 2 mistakes in this formula. Here must be W of skewness, and here also W of skewness, because it's a higher order in velocities. So it's paste and copy and paste mistake. It's very good question, because left-hand side quadratic, and here quadratic. And skewness appear in square. Because it can appear without square in high order moments. I will show why. But here it's because due to symmetry, simply. Please replace W to minus W, okay, in first equation. Right hand side, okay, no, okay. Yeah, yeah. Okay. So he was happy and decided that refined Millionchikov is better than extended Millionchikov. And now, what happens in 10 years after? Martin Losch made the simulation for deep ocean convection. Okay, and find out this functional form perfect. Linear interpolation work. After that, Friedrich Kupka made the simulations with compressible LS. Their plumes have their speed near the Mach number. Okay, very high. Kupka and Robinson. And they simulated sun and stars. After that, Lenshow made the measurements, lidar measurements in Boulder, Colorado. And Peter Sullivan made the LS simulations. It also worked. And recently, it's not full set, and I'm sorry if I not mentioned somebody, but finally, Vagud made the DNS simulations, which I already shown. And this is also confirmed this functional form. And final step was made by Mironov and Mochilskaya, who implemented this model in this parameterization in weather prediction COSMO model. And it also works. So if such situation that then we have the functional form, okay, but all these studies reveal that actually turbulence moments can be as sub-Gaussian as super-Gaussian. That means not always free. It can be larger than free in zero skewness limit and can be smaller. So we decided to make something. So this is a question. What would be a minimalistic model, non-Gaussian, of course, and which can explain all these features which I already mentioned? And how to do this? What would be more or less universal description? And approaches is obvious. There are bulk models, there are Runge models, first, second, third order, and ad hoc models, and also last one, it's LS and DNS models. So we just concentrate on ad hoc model. This is assumed distribution higher order closure model. It consists from several steps. They are obvious. Assume PDF, depending component parameter, solve for parameter in terms of irreducible PDF, find higher order moments in terms of irreducible model moments, test results against measurements LS DNS. If it does not work, repeat again, and repeat again before you reach some reasonable answer. So we quantify, we just decided to follow this problem. Here is a method from Marco Marigola. So it's a realistic signal. This corresponds to this. After that, we come to cubism of Pablo Picasso by simply making projections to PDF description. And finally, we observe that we can approximate actual PDF by updraft motions. The velocity is only positive. Downdraft motions, then velocity negative. And some small scale background, they are around zero. And next step, most promising for analytical studies, is minimalism. Then you just move by replacing by delta functions. For updraft, downdraft, and small-scale turbulence. In analytical representation, everything looks very simple. You have PDF. Here I wrote for simplicity bivariate case. There you have 1, 2, 3, 4 for coherent structure terms and 1 for background for small-scale turbulence. W up here, it's updraft. They can be hot or cold. So you split, you have 9 parameters. And for trivariate 15 and for quadrivariate 25, in all these cases we solve the problem, but I will talk only about variate for simplicity. So what next? Next we have the equations for moments. They look like this. Okay? Any of these moments can be chosen as irreducible. But simplest choice, it's like this. Normalization conditions to zero for mean field, variances, flux, and two third order moments, vertical velocity and temperature. Okay, they really basis for all future. So fortunately, it has nice solution, analytical solution for all moments. And structure, it's similar to Gaussian, but a little bit more complex. Here it's a variances in corresponding power. Here polynom in correlation coefficients, with coefficients which depends upon skewnesses. And PS, it's, you remember it, 1 minus probability of background. Oops, sorry. And this is depends upon PS, all this closure as a parameter. It's like fitting parameter. Area coverage has sense physical, has clear physical meaning. It area coverage in turbulence by semi-organized coherent structures. Okay. And after that, we moved further. This is irreducible moments. This is measurements from aircraft campaigns. Here LS, to which we fit our theory. And here is DNS, which fit data better, but we decided not to have many discussions with people about applicability of DNS for this complex situation to fit to LS. It's easier to explain people because subgrid is more or less normal and everybody knows how it works. So we did this fitting. And now I go to results. This is now without mistakes formula. Here is our closure. This coefficient depends upon concentration of coherent structures. So what we did actually, we matched the moments with physical morphology of coherent structure. If you know morphology, you can tell something about the closures. And now you see how it works. Here nearly perfect corresponds to LS data. Okay. Here parameter there is no background at all. Okay. Here миллиончиков, refined миллиончиков hypothesis, P equal 1/3. And here then we increase or decrease PS concentration of coherent structure to 0.25. You see here. And physically everything is very nicely tractable because if you have more coherent structure, more fluctuations, so we are more long scale, large scale, and you have more contribution, so force of moments must be larger. Okay. And rest of my talk is very simple. This is predicted moments for correlation between heat flux and variances. I have in mind W theta prime with W, for example, here W prime square. And you everywhere have nice formulas depending on PS and have very nice correspondence between data and our results. And next, we did the same for skewness variance calculation. And you see, now we come to answer to Semyon question. Semyon, here it's, you see, it's proportional, oops, sorry. They are proportional to first power of skewnesses because they are not even, but odd modes. Okay, and after that, this is the end. This is summary. I finished. This is summary, technical summary. Technical summary consists of several statements. New exactly solvable model is suggested. Hypothesis, refined миллиончиков hypothesis is proven, and extended, explained by fluctuations by this morphology of flow, and the accuracy is very, very, very good, and not bigger than skater, which exists in numerical model due to subgrid scale closure for LS and in comparison with DNF. Okay, here's romantic conclusion, philosophical. They always means that here you can see the perspective which is coming. And finally, thank you for your kind attention. And here you can read that there are two pessimistic and optimistic view on all everything what was done. Pessimist will tell, okay, that better have no at all fitting constant, and optimist tell, oh, we have reserve for 128. That's all. Spectrum? Okay, there are two types of models. One model is called based spectral models, which is called two-point closure models, okay? But here it's one-point closure models only. So spectrum is beyond the scope of such kind of models. They operate with much more simpler feature, integral of spectrum. Okay, turbulence in recent understanding consists from three components. First component, mean field. Second component, semi-organized structure. And third, homogeneous isentropic turbulence of background. Here it's a mixture of semi-organized structure with small-scale isentropic background. So we don't need actually spectra. Spectra, not good representation for such situation. It fails completely. Yeah. Why it fails? Because you have some self-organization in the system. And spectrum representation, it suggests you quasi-homogeneous randomization of phases and something like this. But it's not necessary. It doesn't work. You must write something like simple closure equations plus additional equation for morphology of structure which are present there. Something in this case, concentration of coherent structure is a good parameter.